Hello, I'm Dr. Tom Graziano, Director of the National Weather Service Office of Water Prediction. The Office of Water Prediction collaboratively researches, develops, and delivers state of the science data and guidance, including national hydrologic analyses, forecast information, and decision support services. These capabilities support and inform essential emergency services and water management decisions. In the United States and around the world, risks to life, property, economies, and ecosystems are increasing due to weather and water-related impacts on an increasing population in vulnerable areas and a changing and warming climate. The expected climate change impacts are manifold, vary regionally, and include an increased frequency of extreme rainfall and flooding. In response to these growing threats, actionable environmental information is needed across a range of audiences and timescales to help all elements of society prepare for, mitigate, and adapt to compounding challenges related to population growth, economic development, deteriorating infrastructure, and coastal change. Flood inundation maps are visualizations that literally put water on a map and show the areal extent of observed and forecast flood water, which when linked with infrastructural, demographic, and other geospatial information, yield critical and actionable intelligence needed to better inform decisions related to mitigating flood impacts. Emergency managers have long articulated that flood inundation maps, or FIM for short, represent the single most important form of actionable intelligence for flood events. During the past two decades, the National Weather Service, in collaboration with federal and other government partners, have generated static FIM libraries for a select number of advanced hydrologic prediction service locations across the nation. However, to meet the growing demand for FIM, and the need to get this information into the hands of decision makers in every community across the nation, the National Water Center, in coordination with river forecast centers, weather forecast offices, and other partners, has developed tools and is demonstrating a capability which provides FIM for every river and stream reach across the nation in a real-time, event-driven, high-resolution, and intuitive way. This effort is supported at the Department of Commerce level and builds upon multiple successful Department of Commerce agency priority goal demonstrations, supporting over 115 million residents across the contiguous United States. This new capability leverages both the River Forecast Center official forecasts for 110,000 miles of rivers across the lower 48 states, as well as forecast guidance from the National Water Model for more than 3.4 million river miles. The National Water Center real-time and forecast FIM deploys a model-agnostic approach to map the extent and depth of volumetric discharge within the National Hydrography Dataset, using both a series of synthetic rating curves developed for channel geometry and a technique referred to as the height above nearest drainage, or HAND for short, to map the water surface elevation in the channel to neighboring cells in the digital elevation model. HAND is applied to the official RFC forecast as issued by the WFOs for over 110,000 miles of river downstream from AHAP's forecast points, leveraging the National Water Model, short and medium range stream flow guidance, an additional 3.4 million miles of river and streams are mapped in the contiguous United States, Hawaii, Puerto Rico, and the U.S. Virgin Islands, enabling critical environmental intelligence to be provided equitably to all communities. As of 2021, these new FIM services are being demonstrated in partnership with National Weather Service field offices and federal partners, while policy, training, and outreach materials are being developed. The National Water Center continues to refine and improve the FIM techniques while continuously integrating digital elevation model enhancements in collaboration with NOAA field offices and other federal partners. Understanding how the various forms of FEM are generated and their respective strengths and weaknesses will enable you to best provide the critical street-level impact-based decision support services, or IDSS, needed by emergency managers and other stakeholders for flood-related events.